Good evening, everybody. I hope you're well, and I hope some of you can hop on for this spontaneous live video. So what I'm talking about is I was talking to someone a minute ago in Messenger about gut health and bloating and stuff, and I'm like, okay, just hop over to the biohacking group and I will go over this really quickly, okay? So bloating and how it works. So loads of people suffer with bloating, as we know, like so many people, and I put it down to our environment, our food, how our food is processed, how our food is sprayed, and blah 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 blah, not taking care of our gut important, or as well as we should. And this all of course results in bloating and gas. So one, I do say this, humans don't produce gas. We don't produce gas. The bacteria in our gut, they produce gas. So the bacteria in our gut, they break down the food, and then depending on the type of food, the specific phylum of bacteria, as they're called, will produce methane. And the methane then, of course, spills up in your gut and it causes bloating and then it causes gas. So that's how it works. Humans don't produce gas, it's the bacteria that produce the gas. So specifically in our gut, we have about 90% of our gut bacteria is two different strains of phylums or two different types of bacteria. The Firmicutes and the Bacteroides. So the Firmicutes are the nasty ones. They're the ones that we don't like. Those are the ones that make us fat. They make our skin break out. Those are the ones that kind of make us gassy and gross. So we want to try control them as much as we can. The Bacteroides, they're the good. Hey, Tara. Those are the good bacteria. And these bacteria keep us lean and they keep us strong and healthy. But sometimes our ratios are very off. And when the ratios are very off, we will experience more bloating and gas. And there's a few ways we can hack this. So if your ratios are off, as in you have too much Firmicutes, so those are the bad bacteria, if you have too much of those, you will experience bloating, inflammation, grossness, gas, acid reflux even, a lot more. So there's a few ways we can hack this. So my first go-to a lot of the time, depending on the individual, because it is very individualized, will be, of course, so I'll ask them what they ate and try and narrow down what's going on. I'll look at their environment. In the case of this specific woman that I was speaking to, I know her food is pretty good. I have a fair idea of how her body is processing and her good health and all, because I've been working close with her. But this week I put it more down to the environment. The air pressure has been affecting a lot of people with all the storms, and when the storms come in, they cause a lot of inflammation. Then the inflammation builds up blood pressure in the head, we get headaches and we get migraines. But because of this, we also get stressed and feel just not ourselves. So then this will cause issues with those Firmicutes, those bad bacteria, and they will start to process foods differently, and that will result in more kind of methane, because when our cortisol rises from the air pressure and feeling crappy and headaches and all that, then our insulin will rise, and then these Firmicutes, they'll cause our body to process sugars even if we haven't consumed sugars, because we know our body can make its own sugars if it needs to, and this then will result in feeling gross and bloated and gassy. So there's a few things that we can do to stimulate your body to bring down the gas. And the bloating. So first things first, I would say do a shot of apple cider vinegar, and that can be very individualized. For some people it'll work immediately and awesomely. For some people it won't work very well. And then of course, I have several pregnant clients right now, and they just don't like the taste of apple cider vinegar, or they can't keep it down. So then we gotta look at other stuff. So the apple cider vinegar, for one, it helps kill off or bring down, because it's very acidic, and these firmicutes or these bad bacteria, they don't like acid. So throwing in some more acid will help kill off some of those and bring down the bloating, and it'll also activate your pancreas to release more enzymes. If you get more enzymes, whatever food you have ingested, you'll be able to break that down even more or better, so there's less likelihood of it being passed then to the colon, where it's going to be fermented and turned into gas, as gross as that sounds. So the apple cider vinegar can do that. So one, it goes in and it'll kill off some of the bad bacteria. But two, apple cider vinegar, and here's something for those of you watching live, a little nugget to take away. I always get asked, can I take apple cider vinegar pills instead of the liquid? Will it be just as beneficial? And I always say, no, it's not going to be beneficial. It will not work. So the key with apple cider vinegar is the taste, the bitterness. As soon as that hits our tongue, we have a nerve that goes through our whole body. It's called the vagus nerve, and it begins on our tongue. And once that gets stimulated by bitterness or sourness or very tartness, that sends a signal down to your stomach and your pancreas saying, hey, let's get ready for digestion. So the pancreas then will excrete more enzymes, and then the stomach will start stimulating more acid to get ready to break down more food. So that's why you need the liquid form. The pills don't work at all. Like, they're going to do nothing for you. By the time they get broken down, they're processed and all, you wouldn't even get the benefits of them. So it has to be liquid. So we would stimulate more enzymatic action by having apple cider vinegar. We can also then, and this has been shown to help flush out the digestive tract or your intestines a little quicker, so you can kind of get rid of that bloating, is of course you've heard of peppermint tea is going to be very beneficial, because it just soothes everything, it calms everything down and flushes, helps things move through the colon or the intestines a little bit quicker. But green tea will also do that. And obviously, if it's after a specific time of the day and you don't sleep very well or you're sensitive to caffeine, you want to monitor your green tea intake at a certain time of day. But green tea is very, very effective at bringing down bloating, and just getting rid of those gas. Again, how that works is, that's one, there's a bit of tartness or a bit of bitterness in green tea, especially if you stew it for a little bit longer, but it's very high in polyphenols. So green tea, those polyphenols are like poison, so they can come in and kind of kill any of those firmicutes that are acting up and causing you to bloat or be gas. So that's how green tea works, and it's pretty effective. Like, it's really effective. I'll use that if I have issues. It'll be a green tea and a shot of apple cider vinegar, and usually 20 or so minutes, I'm good to go. Okay, so if that doesn't work, you don't like green tea, you don't like apple cider vinegar, what would we do next? We would do warm water with a tablespoon or so of organic lemon juice or lime juice. Again, that's that bitter component, and it's that acid being thrown into your stomach and down into your duodenum and everything like that to kill off some of these bacteria that are acting up at the time. So if you don't then have lemon or lime juice, what would you do? Okay, just warm water will work as well. So warm water has been shown to be able to stimulate the pancreas and get enzymes working and tell your body that food is coming. So if you have digestion issues, hey Josh, if you have digestion issues, And you know it, and you struggle to digest food, and you don't have any digestive enzymes lying around. And that's another thing you can use, is you can implement digestive enzymes into your main meals. But if you don't have any of that, it's been shown that if you have warm water about 15 minutes before a meal, that warm water will stimulate the stomach and the pancreas and get everything ready for digestion, so you digest even better. Unfortunately, cold water has been shown to shut down digestion. So you don't want to really do that. You want to go for that warm water. So there's a lot of hacks you can do to get things moving. If you don't have any other vinegars, balsamic vinegar will work. It will work. Regular malt vinegar will work as well. Even if you just want a little bit, that's going to take that bloating down. You can just mix a bit in warm water and shoot it back, and you're going to get rid of that bloating as well. Worst case scenario, that you don't even have warm water around, you can do some massaging of the bowel area. I don't know, those of you that have had babies probably remember how to massage the bowel area in an anti-clockwise kind of motion to get things moving. Or sometimes, as uncomfortable as it is, doing some abdominal or core work or crunches can actually bring down bloating, believe it or not, because it stimulates digestion and it stimulates the activity. So there's a whole host of stuff that you can do. If you do struggle with a lot of digestive issues, you might want to look into maybe a hydrochloric acid supplement. You can buy them everywhere. Betaine, it might say, it's the same thing. Some of them also come with fenugreek. Fenugreek is known to help with digestion. You can also get fenugreek tea. Like, there's so much stuff you can do. But that is how it all works. Well, mostly there's a lot more to it, but that's kind of the basics. That's what I think you just need to know. And I will chat to you guys soon, because I plan to go over how the gut bacteria works in a bit more in depth over the next day or two, just because I know I've put out some posts about gut bacteria and gut health over the last few weeks, but I don't think people quite understand it. So videos like this can be very helpful. So have a great Friday evening, everybody. I hope that made sense. If you've got any questions, drop them below. You know I'm pretty good with answering. And I'll chat later. Thanks for hopping on, Shannon. It's good to start seeing you again. Megan, of course. Josh, Constance, I hope you're well. Rebecca, Tara, everyone have a great evening. Okay, bye.